Hi guys, my name is Lisa. Welcome to my YouTube channel. So, as I said, my name is Lisa. You can call me Lisa or you can call me Bissy. Some people call me Lisa, some people call me Bissy, and LB for short, hence the name of my channel, LB O'Clock. So I thought I would do a little introductory video in terms of who I am, what I do, and what the purpose of my YouTube channel is as well, just so it gives you guys an opportunity to, I guess, get to know me a little bit better and kind of, yeah, just vibe a little bit with you guys. But I'm going to be looking at my phone a lot because I've written a few things down in terms of what I want to talk about and stuff like that. But I will also be doing a Q&A at the end again to give you an opportunity to get to know me a little bit more. But yeah, so the main purpose of my channel is kind of, it's going to be about like travel vlogs, fashion, stuff like that. So I do travel a lot, sometimes for work, but mostly for leisure as well. I've been to a few countries and a lot of my holidays are solo holidays. So I love going on holiday by myself, which may sound weird. But if you haven't tried at least one holiday by yourself, guys, I definitely advise that you do it. It will blow your mind. It will literally be the best decision you ever make. Like, it's so amazing just being able to, I guess, just be free, do what you want to do. Like me, for example, I like water sports. I love water sports. And with some people, that's how they will now be saying, oh, I don't want to go ski, what's it called, jet skiing. I don't want to do this. And I'm so sorry, more need time for people. Yeah, I actually don't have time for that. So I love the fact that when I'm on holiday by myself, it's basically up to me to plan what I want to do. So I thought, when I'm on holiday, I always record everything. I'm always recording, always snapping. So I thought, why not? Why not create a YouTube channel where I can kind of take you guys along with me and vlog my experiences in terms of the different countries I go to and that, you know, the different things that I do. My channel will also be kind of focusing on my travels to Nigeria. If you didn't know already by my name, Bissy, I am Nigerian, I'm Yoruba. And I tend to go to Nigeria a lot. The plan is in the very, 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 very near future to move to Nigeria. I will be kind of making a video in terms of why I want to move to Nigeria, my plans when I move to Nigeria as well. But that will be in the next couple of weeks. I'll make a video to kind of give you guys more of an insight again into my plans and why I want to move there. I was in Nigeria, in fact, for Easter, and I have a vlog that I will be uploading very soon. I'm just editing at the moment. I will upload it very soon, which hopefully will give you guys an idea again of what Nigeria is like, if you are not Nigerian, and even if you are, if you haven't visited, it will give you an idea of what Nigeria is like and what I'm getting up to whilst I'm out there as well. So this channel will kind of be a little bit dedicated to kind of like my move to Nigeria, like updating you guys regularly in terms of what I do, but also vlogging when I go there as well. And as I said, because I plan on moving to Nigeria, I will be kind of doing a video for you guys in terms of hints and tips in terms of whether you want to move to Nigeria, whether you just want to visit Nigeria, give you information about where to go to eat, places to go to hang out, clubs that you can go to, activities to do in Nigeria, especially Lagos, because when I go, I usually only stay in Lagos. I've been to Abuja a few times, but my trips are usually to Lagos because that's where I plan to move to when I move to Nigeria. So I'll be giving you guys a lot more information and tips and hints and tips about that. But particularly for my ladies, because guys, I got your back. I'll be giving you some hints and tips in terms of how to not get lost in the sauce in Nigeria. Because I'm not going to lie, I've been there. Sister, like, as much as I hate to say it, I have been finessed in Nigeria. They have taken your girl for a mug, but they're not going to do that to me again. And I'm going to be giving you guys some hints and tips in terms of how not to get lost in the sauce, how to not be finessed by a Lagos guy. Because you know these Lagos guys, when you say Yoruba demon, their mouth is sweet like sugar cane. They will just use words to now serenade you, and you two will be doing, not knowing that they're out there to get you. So I'll be giving you guys some hints and tips in terms of how not to get lost in the sauce and stuff like that. So there will be a lot of videos in terms of my vlog, my travels, but also not only to Nigeria, but a lot of the videos may be to Nigeria in terms of my move and stuff like that, and hints and tips in terms of, also actually, I forgot, for my Nigerians, I'll be giving you some tips in terms of how to deal with the whole getting your passport, the process in terms of going to the Nigerian embassy, which is not a joke. That place is not for the faint-hearted at all. Listen, that place will either make or break you. If you're not careful, they will scatter your brain in that place. So I guess that's enough talking for me. As I said, there will be a bit of a Q&A at the end. I have 10 questions here that would, I hope, give you guys an opportunity to get to know me a little bit better. If there are any questions you have for me once I've answered all these questions, do leave them down below in the comment section. Do follow me on socials. My Snapchat and Twitter handle is Lisa I Love Christ. I do have Instagram, guys. I do. But the only problem, however, is that you guys are gonna laugh when I show you this year. This, I don't know if you can see it, is my Instagram logo. This is the icon for my Instagram. I have not, guys, updated my Instagram in 5 years, since I want to say 2014 or 2015. That was the last time I updated my Instagram app. I refuse to update it. You know, this new Instagram is so confusing. I don't get it, and I'm sorry, I cannot come and bust my brain because of Nitori. Instagram is not that deep, so I refuse to update it, but eventually I know I will have to. But for now, guys, please don't follow me on Instagram because you will not be interacting with me on there. In fact, Instagram have logged me out because the app is not functional again. So yeah, let's get straight into the Q&A. So the first question is, where are you from / where were you born? So if you didn't know already by my name, I am Nigerian, I'm Yoruba, proud, loud and proud, Omo Niger. But yeah, I'm Yoruba. Where was I born? I was born in the UK, I was born in Essex, born and bred in Essex, but I have actually lived in Nigeria as well. I lived in Nigeria for about 4 years, which for me was an amazing experience because it gave me an opportunity to kind of learn more about my culture and actually be embedded in the Nigerian culture. But even more important, it gave me an opportunity to kind of to learn my language, which for me is so amazing because as much as I am British, I feel like it's imperative for me to be able to communicate in my language. So do you speak, this question actually leads on very well from what I just mentioned. Do you speak any other languages? Yes, I speak Yoruba, which is a one of the numerous languages in Nigeria. People always think, oh, Nigeria is just Yoruba, Hausa, or Igbo. No, Maji, there are so many different languages and dialects in Nigeria. But yeah, that's the only other language I speak to. So the next question is, what is your favorite color? My favorite color, guys, is khaki. Like, my friends will know this. Yeah, you guys don't understand. I have khaki jeans. I have khaki bed sheets. I have khaki skirt, khaki top, khaki eyeshadow. Anything khaki, I have khaki backpack. Where am I? I have khaki bag. Like, I love me some khaki. Like, I feel like it's just such a nice color. Like, no matter whether it's in the winter or in the summer, it's just such a popping color. I love it so much. Like, I think it just looks good on me. How many siblings do you have? I have 3 siblings, all sisters. So what is your favorite song at the moment? Listen, you see right now, yeah, I have 2 faves. Like, these 2 songs, when I hear them, yeah, I wanna best it. Like, I wanna zanku and leg work. Like, literally, like, I wanna get up and just shake my body. But my first one is Royal Rumble, like Lil Kesh and Damo Marley. That song, yeah, I don't feel like people are taking that song in. Like, that song is so fire. Like, I don't know what it is yet, but that song just gingers me. Like, I'm gingered. My second favorite song is Killing Them, Burna Boy and Zlatan. I feel like that song is just lit. The beat is just so fire. But yeah, those are my 2 favorite songs at the moment. So what are the first 3 things that I notice about a guy? The first thing, for me, for example, I am the Oud queen. I love a Oud, you know. I love a good Oud. I love a scented lotion. I love a perfume. I love scents. Like, I love a scented candle. Like, I love it. I love a wet scented candle. But scents are my thing. So if a guy walks past me and he's got, like, a nice scent, it's like, sorry. Hey, sorry. Like, I love a nice scent. So second thing is teeth. Don't come and talk to me if your teeth is doing this, because I will send you back to where you came from. I will have to ask if everything is alright. Because how are you talking to me? All I'm seeing is crinkle and crinkle again. And your teeth is just doing this. Like, teeth is a massive deal to me. But if your teeth are scattered, can you piss off? Can you get lost? Don't talk to me. I can't deal with scattered teeth. No, I cannot. I'd say the last thing, shoes. And don't get me wrong, guys, I'm not talking about brands or designer or whatever. That's not, I don't care about all of that. But shoes are a big deal. If you're not pairing the right shoe and the right skinny jean, the whole outfit is destroyed. I'm sorry. So if your shoes are scattered, please, again, can you slide over to another person? Don't come to me, because I'm just going to look at you and tell you, order board, don't chat to me. Like, shoes, scents, and teeth, massive deals. Like, if they're not on point, go away. Seven is, what's your favorite scent? Three favorite scents at the moment. Bearing in mind, like I said, I have so much wood. Like, I might one of these days show you my wood collection. My three favorite scents at the moment is Lancome. I don't know if I'm saying the name right. I'm not sure if I ever say this name right. But Lancome I don't know where it is, but I'm going to write it down in the video so you guys, before I start doing grammatical error, I will write it down so you guys can see it, yeah? My second favorite, actually no, I'll say this is my number one favorite scent of all time. Tom Ford Nordenau. Listen, that scent, yeah, sister, like, I will speak in tongues right now. I love it. It's just so, oh, it just hugs you and you're just like, oh, like, like, you just feel like a queen. It's, I love it. It's just such a beautiful scent. I just feel like Tom Ford in general, their scents, yeah, are sensational. But I love Nordenau. Nordenau is my favorite scent. Another scent that I really like at the moment is Dolce & Gabbana, the one. I don't know where it is yet. When you first spray it, it's banging. But give it 2 minutes once it's settled. Oh my goodness. You just feel like you've bathed in it. Literally two squirts and you're just smelling luscious for the whole day. I love it. What is your favorite feature about yourself? This one I don't even have to think of. Every time people ask me, I know. My back. You see me? Nah, my back is my favorite feature. So I have a birthmark on my back. I don't know if you guys can see it here. Like, I have a big birthmark there. I remember when I was younger, like, I used to, that, like, birthmark used to, it just used to upset me. You know how kids are bad mind? Like, they used to say, oh, I had shit stain, sorry. Like, I had poo stain on my back. Like, kids are horrible. They just used to pick on me about it. And I hated it so much. But then I think it was when I got to secondary school, yeah. I just decided that I can't come and kill myself. Like, what can I do? I can't get rid of it. I can't scrub it off. I'm going to embrace it and I'm going to love it. I'm going to work it. Now my favorite feature is my back. So my phone is on Do Not Disturb 365 days a year. It's on Do Not Disturb every single day. And it's not even one of those Do Not Disturbs that once you ring it twice, it goes through. No, it's on. Once you ring it, you'll ring it again and again and again and again and again, and it will keep going to voicemail. So if you've called me 2 times, yeah, and it's not gone through, why are you calling me 7 times? That thing gets me, like, it pisses me off. Why are you calling me so many times, please? Like, I'm not really a phone call kind of girl. I'm more of, I love a text, you know. You see my thumbs, yeah? I've got strong thumbs. Like, they will be clicking away. Like, I love a good text. Like, I love it. So, I'm not really a phone call kind of girl. So, if you're calling me 7 times, yeah, and it's not an emergency, like, are you mad? Do you pay my phone bill? Why are you calling me so many times? That thing pisses me off so much. But the final question, guys, question number 10, is how many countries have you visited? I have counted 14 countries. But that doesn't count visiting one country multiple times. So, for example, the Canary Islands, I've been to 4 of them. So I've only counted that as one country. So I would say, but it's probably up to maybe 19 countries. But I've only counted 14 or 15 because I haven't counted my multiple visits to, like, maybe the Canary Islands, for example. So, yeah. Yeah, about 14 or 15. But yeah, that's the end of the Q&A, guys. Have time, but as I said, if you have any other questions for me, definitely follow me on Snapchat, follow me on Twitter, ask me any questions, direct message me, whatever it is. But also ask me any questions in the comment section. I'll definitely, you know, answer any questions that are not too enough. Thank you guys so much for watching my video. Thank you so much for following me, for subscribing, for liking and sharing. I will definitely be seeing you guys in my next video. But